writing partners, Bill Weir was my first writing partner. We just got together about late 1964. He initially taught me how to write, taught me how to play. Helped me meet Tommy Boyce. Taught me the ins and outs of taking your song around publishers and record companies. Took me into my first recording studio, encouraged me, fought like brothers. We were together till 1970. We parted ways, differences of opinions, but all in all, we probably wrote about 100 songs together. I'll never forget him. Good man. Still around today. My second writing partner was Mark Seeloft. Mark had lived in my neighborhood since I was 14. I remember him going to Rosemont Junior High. I was always two steps ahead of him as far as grades. I was already out of high school by about a year when I met him again through my girlfriend, who was in the same grade as he was. But it was Mark's group, Mother Barrel. Actually, their drummer, Rick Giles, who introduced me. She introduced me to Rick, and Rick introduced me to the band. And the band helped me record a song, Maybe I'm a Fool. After which, we decided to form a band called Freeway. Mother Barrel was breaking up. Rick chose not to join us. And Mark had a friend named Dave Chapman that he introduced us to. Mark and I had already written some songs. They were a bit zany, probably in an Alice Cooper mode. We played them for Dave. We said, well, what do you think? And he said, I'm in. And so we recorded our first CD, Playing on the Freeway. She was recorded live at Larry's house. So what you hear is what you get. We tried taking that music around and nobody was really interested. We started work on the second batch of songs, and halfway through, Larry left, and Keith, and that put us down to about three. In between that, we were playing, actually, we were asked to be backup players for this woman named Beth Beatty, who wrote the song Nobody, Three Out Night. And she wanted us to the song Autusi. Not a great song, but she took it around to several backers and they liked it. And nobody really took a bite, but all of us basically left the Beth band, and Mark and Keith stayed. Still, you know, doing Cyrus Round. And several singers went through that group. In the meantime, David got into this band called the Mike Harrison Band. And David recommended me to the leader of the band, the singer, Mike Harrison. And I took him about 20 songs. He liked them all and he wanted to record them, which we did. And we were all signed to Warner Brothers. But basically, the whole thing fell apart after we had recorded it and the music was shelved. Instead of going on a European tour that he had planned, everybody quit the band. And so, back to service round, and we completed the second set of the album. That would be called At the Rock House. And we proceeded to work on another album's worth of songs. And continued basically to do about two albums worth of songs, and one would later be called Visions. And about 1980, the band broke up in the partnership. And for about 2 years, I wrote with a guy in Pelly Smythe. We probably did about 20, 30 songs together. Mark and I had done about 200 songs together, the other band. Tommy moved on. He had other things going on. And I kind of did some solo things. And the band got back together in about 2005. And we started getting together all the music we had and putting out CDs, albums of our songs. David, our drummer, passed away in 2010. But we finished up the album. Took us about 5 years. It finally was released in 2015. The band finally broke up about a year ago. In between time, from about 2000 to 2014, my next writing partner was John Vandrill. He wrote maybe close to 100 songs together. I taught John how to write music. He was great with lyrics. He was great with music. And I wish we could have continued, but he moved away and got married. And it's always open to continue, as with anything, with Larry and Dave. And John wrote some really great songs. What I liked the best was It's a Lonely Road. Great, just great, great lyrics. And so I've used Stephen's Corner to introduce these songs that Rob Rick Malvish, different writing partners. And they like what I've done. And that's it.